quite interestingly, there's now a there's a question raised regarding the identity of Mr. Echanis. What do you say to that? And number one, who actually identified the victim in that Quezon City home?
Yes, the identification card stating that the picture similar to Randall Echanis and the name was different, Manuel Santiago, is really immaterial, Christian, because in the morning when reports came, the wife, Linda Echanis, verified and identified the cadaver in pink petals sa funeral homes by virtue of a video call, because she is an elderly, she's a senior citizen with a lot of illnesses. So she authorized somebody through the lawyer of Centra and went to the La Loma funeral home, pink petals, and saw the cadaver and let the employee of the funeral homes called Linda to identify whether or not the body is belonging to Randall Echanis, which she did and positively identified, unfortunately. And they started the process of reclaiming the body for a proper wake, supposedly. Unfortunately, after all the efforts were made, transfer na sana doon sa ibang funeral homes, relatively nearer to our location. The police of La Loma Police Station, through the instruction of NCRPO de Bolsinas, attempted and successfully stopped the body from transferring and pinabalik doon sa La Loma Police Station. La Loma funeral homes.
Was it true that there was no proper release order from the previous funeral home when the body was transferred?
Well, the family, the representatives of the lawyers and the family complied with all the necessary requirements in claiming, in identifying and claiming a cadaver. Okay. There's no business for the police station or for the police in any way to intervene and to disrupt and even to stop the family from grieving. No, if they say that the investigation should continue, they can investigate. Even in every location, the family decides where to put the wake. Mm-hmm. Hindi po yan desisyon ng kapulisan kung saan nila gusto mag-imbestiga at doon lang ilimita yung katawan. No?
But how about the autopsy?
It's the decision of the family.
How about the autopsy?
Well, the autopsy, we have already arranged an autopsy, and the autopsy will be made on will be conducted on Wednesday, tomorrow.
So it was the family that arranged for the autopsy, not the police?
Yes, yes. Yes, the autopsy, the conduct of autopsy should be decided first by the family. It should not be an automatic decision of the police. We have the right, the family has the right to choose our own manner of how the body should be autopsied.
Okay.
As long as it is legally compliant.
Okay. Now, what do we know so far regarding the cause of death? Of course, pending the results of the official autopsy.
Yes.
Because there are certain conflicting reports.
Yeah.
Initially, allegedly, he was gunned down and then he was stabbed to death. What do we know so far?
At the post-mortem result last night revealed that two gunshot wounds at the back of the head and multiple stab wounds. No, hindi pa malalaman kung sa proper autopsy pa malalaman kung ano yung mga entry point ng stab wounds, exit point. But there are multiple stab wounds indicated in the different parts of the back body of Randall Echanis. Therefore, two gunshot wounds in the back part of the head and multiple stab wounds in the back part of the body.
By the way, was that the house of Mr. Echanis?
Was
that the house of Mr. Echanis?
No, that was a rented apartment.
And he was staying there?
Yes.
Okay, now, have you spoken with witnesses or neighbors who might have heard or even seen some people enter the house that evening?
Yes, we have already collected several persons and identities for possible issuance of testimonies or they would have they will be issuing testimonies and statements that will support probably our case filing.
But who do you think did this? Because when I saw your initial statement, I think you pertained to a police raid. Were you sure it was the police that went inside and killed him?
This is politically motivated, Christian. First of all, the affiliations of Mr. Echanis, Anakpawis chairperson, KMP deputy secretary general, and especially his involvement in the peace panel of the National Democratic Front of the Philippines as a consultant to the socio-economic reforms, let alone those affiliations under this regime, is being criminalized, being terrorized, being tagged as a communist.
Okay.
These affiliations also resulted to previous.
How did you arrive at that initial finding or suspicion that it was that the killing happened during a police raid?
No. We highly suspect. We did not conclude. No.
At so that was
time.
A suspicion.
We highly suspect.
But how many people were seen entering the house based on your conversations with the witnesses?
Yes, we will be releasing publicly the chronology of possible events that transpired before and during the killing of Mr. Echanis. But one thing is for sure, around 12 midnight, seven civilian plainclothes men wearing ski masks or masks was already in the outside of the apartment unit of Mr. Echanis.
And then they barged in?
They barged in. They forcibly kicked the door that resulted to the unhitch ng pintuan.
Okay, pero sino po yung kasama ni Mr. Echanis dun sa bahay? I understand there was another fatality, right?
Yes, at that time he was alone. The another fatality was a neighbor living besides the next apartment unit.
Bakit siya nadamay?
Well, he heard, according to the witnesses, he heard commotion in the room or the next door sa apartment ni Mr. Echanis because they were friends from the time na Mr. Echanis rented the house or the apartment unit. They were occasionally and regularly acquainted with each other. Then they became friends. No. Unfortunately, when the person heard commotion in the unit of Mr. Echanis, he checked, and then he was snatched or nabbed, forcibly taken inside. And he was killed also.
Finally, Mr. Casilao, you said that he had been staying there for a while now, that he had been renting the house. But I understand he was suffering from a particular illness. Nagpapagaling siya rin sa area, doon sa bahay.
Yes, yes.
Ano yung sakit niya?
Well, he has hypertension. Meron po siyang yung lumalaki yung sa pusod ng tiyan. He was actually nagkaroon siya ng mga series of medical checkups in the recent months. Ang alam ko, nagpa-check up siya sa mga hospitals para doon sa kanyang medical condition.
Okay, Mr. Ariel Casilao, thank you very much for joining us this morning, sir.
Thank you, Christian.
Let's now get the latest on the police investigation into Echanis' death. We have with us Police Lieutenant Johanna Sazon, the Chief of the Quezon City Police District's Public Information Office. Good morning, Lieutenant Sazon, and thank you very much for joining us.
Yes, sir. Good morning.
Okay, first, let's clarify this. Why did the police retrieve the body of Mr. Echanis? And number two, are we sure that it was Mr. Echanis? Because I think the police were raising doubts regarding that. But according to Mr. Casila, we just spoke with him now, the wife herself identified positively the body of Mr. Echanis.
Hello?
Yes, Abo. Did you hear my question, po?
Pardon, please?
Okay. Did you hear my question or ulitin ko po?
okay ulit po. Yung unang isang question lang muna.
Oh, sige. Yung bakit ano? Bakit kinuha ng pulis yung katawan ni Mr. Echanis?
Sir, regarding that, I don't have any, any reports yet. I will ask the our criminal investigation inspection unit regarding that po.
Oo. Tapos number two,
I still don't have a report regarding that po.
Oo. Now regarding yung identity, I think the investigators or the police were raising questions regarding the identity of the body of the person who was killed in Novaliches, Quezon City. Na-establish na ba talaga ng police na it was
regarding his identity, according po dun sa but report from our criminal investigation detection unit, it was Manuel Santiago.
Based on what? The ID?
Based on the ID.
Oh, pero
and based on the statement of the landlady of the apartment.
Based on the statement
that
of
he is Manuel Santiago, yeah.
Statement of the landlady.
Yeah.
Okay.
Nagpakilala po siya na siya si Manuel Santiago nung sa landlady and sa ID din po na pinresent po.
Okay. Pero it's possible. Yeah, because it's possible that he might have been perhaps hiding his identity perhaps because of a threat. Pero according to Mr. Casilao, we interviewed him just a few moments ago, the wife herself identified positively the body na si Mr. Echanis daw 'yon.
Regarding po dyan, sir, kailangan po natin ng proof to prove na siya po talaga si Echanis na sinasabi po nila. So we are appealing to the kung sino man pong relative na makapagtulungan po sa Cebu for possible identification po talaga kung siya po talaga ay si Chinese or si Manuel Santiago. So, like fingerprint or DNA test, ganun po sir.
Pero hindi ba sapat yung positive identification? Let's say nakita na nung asawa through video call daw yung katawan and she identified him as the husband.
Under investigation po kasi sir kaya kailangan po talaga natin ng proof na kung talagang siya po talaga yon true doon po siguro like yun nga po sa DNA or sa fingerprint po.
O nga, so madali namang masettle yun, di ba? Through fingerprint or you don't have to go into a DNA test, right? And then, kakausapin nyo ba yung asawa
yes,
to again identify him?
Yes, sir. Makapagtulong, makipag-report lang po sila sa Cebu, sir, para po doon po sa, like, fingerprint, para po ma-identify na talaga siya po. Kung sino po talaga siya, kung si Echanis po ba, or si Manuel Santiago po.
And then, who will conduct the autopsy?
The crime lab, sir.
So, the Philippine National Police. And then, how soon will the body be returned to the family?
Hindi ko pa po alam yan, sir. I will ask the our crime lab regarding that.
Oh. Tapos may mga na-identify na ba at nakausap yung Quezon City Police sa mga witnesses, let's say mga kapitbahay, sa kung ano yung nakita or narinig nila during that evening?
Hello?
Hello?
Hello? Ano po yun, sir?
May na-identify na ba yung police na mga witnesses na maaaring nakakita or nakarinig ng kung ano nung gabi na iyon?
Meron naman po, sir. Meron po.
Makailan po yung witnesses meron. na-identify so far?
Based on the spot report, sir, isa lang po ang nandoon. Narinig niya na mayroon pong loud noise dun sa inside the apartment po.
Pero may nakita raw ba yung witness na mga pumasok?
Yun pa lang po nakalagay sa spot report, sir. May narinig po siyang ingay doon sa inside the apartment po.
Okay. Ang sabi ko, pero tapos na bang ma-process yung crime scene? I mean, everything that had to be done had been completed?
Tapos na po, sir. Yesterday.
Oo. Kasi ang sabi ni Mr. Ariel Casilao, yung dating Congressman Anakpawis, nakausap natin kanina lang, based na sa conversations nila ron sa ibang mga witnesses, they were able to, the witnesses allegedly saw at least 7 men wearing ski masks and wearing civilian clothes enter or barge into the apartment. And then, may mga nadinig.
Hello?
Malinaw po ba yung
yes,
dating?
According kasi kay... Oo, medyo po, sir.
According po kay dating Anakpawis.
According kay?
Ariel Casilao.
Anakpawis Casilao.
Oo.
Ano daw po yung jerk?
Meron daw silang mga witnesses na nakausap at ayon sa mga witnesses, meron daw silang nakita na at least 7 men wearing ski masks at naka-civilian clothes na pumasok dun sa bahay. Tugma po ba ito dun sa mga nalaman ng police based sa investigation ng gabi na yun?
I still don't have any progress report po na galing sa CDU regarding po dyan sa mga witnesses na yan, sir.
Okay. Lieutenant Johanna Sazon, thank you very much for joining us this morning.
Okay, po, sir. Thank you.